As the doxing, protests, and overall incivility heat up here in Washington and beyond, some are focusing on comments from prominent Democrats like Cory Booker earlier this summer.
That's my call to action here. Please don't just come here today and then go home. Go to the Hill today. Get up and please get up in the face of some Congress people.
Republican Senator Rand Paul's wife, who remembers well the attack on her husband last year, has sent an open letter to Senator Booker and to others. She's asking him to walk back those comments. She says, quote, "I now keep a loaded gun by my bed. In the last 18 months, our families experienced violence and threats of violence at a horrifying level." Kelley Paul joins us now to talk about that. Welcome, Kelley. Good to have you.
Thanks for having me, Shannon.
What made you at this point reach out and do the letter? Because we all remember your husband was at the shooting last year that almost killed Congressman Scalise.
Yes.
He was personally attacked, 6 ribs broken, serious lung damage. People don't even understand, I think, the extent of his injuries. And where are we at now for you guys as far as day-to-day existence?
You know, I was really motivated to write the letter just from the incredible activities I've watched the last week. I mean, seeing Heidi and Ted Cruz forced out of the restaurant in D.C. last week, and people in their face, you know, waving their middle finger, getting in their face, not allowing them to even eat their meal. And then when our address, our home address in Bowling Green, Kentucky, was released on the internet and Rand's personal cell phone was released, you know, I felt incredibly threatened and frightened. I had been frightened when Rand left for D.C. that Monday because, you know, the new message is get up in their face, get in people's face. And I don't think people realize just how threatening that feels, how violated you feel when someone invades your personal space like that. It certainly doesn't help to move the discourse along or change any hearts and minds. But the night I wrote that, I was sitting in my house and I saw the sheriff's car go by my house really slowly, and I was grateful for it. I was grateful for their, you know, continued surveillance of our home. But I just felt so sad. It was like, how did we get here?
Gotten to that point. I want to read something from Jeff Gertz, who's a spokesman for Senator Booker. He thinks that clip that a lot of people have seen is taken out of context. He says, Senator Booker actually says to a nonpartisan, nonprofit organization dedicated to ending homelessness to get up in the face of some Congress people and tell them about common sense solutions that address that problem. And he said, I don't want to hate anybody because I know the truth. Gertz went on to say, to think Senator Booker somehow urging violent confrontation with these words requires you to ignore all context. Now, we've seen on the Hill over the last few days, Democrats and Republicans alike, now many of them choosing to walk with police escorts because we've seen the hallways, the threats, people in their faces. This is happening on both sides of the aisle. How does it change? What would you like to see?
You know, one of the reasons that I addressed my letter to Senator Booker is because he and Rand have worked together in a bipartisan way on criminal justice reform, which is an issue that I feel really passionately about. And I've been very involved with a group called Justice Action Network. And we are pushing for the First Step Act. This is something that I think we could actually get passed in a bipartisan way. And I was preparing to come to D.C. for a conference at Microsoft tomorrow, and I started thinking, you know, the world is so polarized right now up here that I fear that we will never be able to move forward on any of these issues. And words do matter, and perhaps he didn't mean it in such an aggressive way, but when you are the recipient of people getting up in your face, it does feel extremely personal. And certainly from our perspective, since Rand has been shot at and physically attacked in the last year, and then on the heels of our personal home address being released, I felt extremely vulnerable and I felt extremely threatened. And I hope that we can move beyond this. Whatever happens, you know, with the confirmation, I do hope that we can move beyond this and find some solutions for things like criminal justice reform that in the past have had broad bipartisan support.
Yeah, we hope those conversations happen on any topics that can bring everybody to the table, because people on all sides of this particular controversy have been threatened, and none of us thinks that's okay. Kelley Paul, thank you for sharing your story.
Thank you for having me.